fantastic day at the Jeongseon Alpine Centre, the Gaowang Mountain, bathed in sunshine. Day 8 of the 2018 PyeongChang Olympic Winter Games, and it's ladies' Super G day here, and a gold medal will be decided. The first gold medal in the speed events for the ladies, and who will take home the top prize in women's Super G ski racing. Competition delayed for about an hour because of high winds this morning, but they have thankfully calmed down and we are good to go. We are led to believe for the ladies Super G here at the Jeongseon Alpine Centre very, very shortly. Last week the women were skiing the technical events over the Yongpyeong Mountain. This week it's speed events at the Jeongseon Alpine Centre. The two venues hosting the men in the first week here and then over to Yongpyeong in the second week as we look back up towards the start of the Super G and getting us underway. Bib number one, Lindsey Vonn, in a quest for a second Olympic gold medal to add to the downhill gold she won at the Vancouver Games in 2010. What a story that would be. Heartbreaking missing Sochi 4 years ago after picking up a horrendous knee injury at the Schladming World Championships in the Super G. She tried to make it back for Sochi, it didn't work. Can she sign off on her Olympic quest with a gold medal? Perfect conditions for Super G racing here today.
Yeah, it's ideal. Having a look on inspection, the snow is really firm. It's not quite icy, but it's hard and it's a smooth track, and it's going to be a really fair race from the first starter to the very last start number, which is fantastic. The winds have died down and it really is set for a fantastic event.
Fortunately, the snow is cold enough, so even with this sunshine, it shouldn't start to break up as the later bib numbers come down. It should hold firm, and so a good track for all the competitors at the top of the mountain. Let's have a look at the track designed by Bernard Roussy, and they start just before Dragon Claw, the second jump, which will be on the downhill track. It's the first jump in the Super G. Then over Jong Bon Drop, and then they cut to their right, down at Dragon's Back, before coming round Magic Tree, shaping up for the final jump, the Ararang jump, then down into the finish area. The start altitude, 1,130 meters. It's a drop of 585, and it's just over 2 kilometers in length. Bernard Roussy, of course, the men's Olympic downhill champion from Sapporo in 1972. He designed the downhill course in Sochi. He's designed the downhill course here. French represented by Tessa Worley, Tiffany Gauthier, and Romani Miradoli. Here is the start list. 45 competitors from 25 National Olympic Committees, and Lindsey Vonn, the most decorated World Cup female skier, gets us underway. Italy have good shouts with Schnaff and Fanchini and Brignoni and, of course, Goggia. Lara Gut of Switzerland, the leader of the Super G standings, goes at 5. Tina Weirather looking to add to the family gold medal haul. Her mother did the technical double back in 1980 in Lake Placid. And just the 45 athletes at the top of the hill. Number 35, Greta Small. She's been through her injuries in the last 4 years. And number 41, Sabrina Simada, becoming the first Kenyan woman to appear at the Winter Olympic Games. The youngest athlete in the field, number 42. It is Elevthina Musa Feria from Bosnia-Herzegovina. So no point of view run for us to view today. So where are the key areas of this track?
Well, looking up on the course, the jump's always very important to get the line correct, to go over to carry all your speed from one section into the next. The forest road from the downhill, it falls away to the left and it's quite bumpy going across there. So again, carry your speed through that section without any hesitation. That's gonna be really key. Down here on the lower part of course, it's so that through the drag and back, almost every other turn, there's a blind roll. And so it's gonna be really important to, for all of the starters to stay committed to what they saw in inspection and to go through without any hesitation. And that is what makes Super G so exciting, because they get one inspection, one look at it in the morning, and then you push out of the start gate and it's race time. You have to take those risks and you have to go out and find the speed where you can be, it can be had.
Super G, you only get an inspection, no training run. You do get a free ski on the hill, but you don't get a training run on the pattern of gate. So very different skill to downhill. The top half of the course, we feel, is more a Super G. The bottom half are more of a GS style. So perhaps Vicky Rabensberg of Germany might be in with a shout. That was Atli Skordal, the race referee, on the radio. And he'll be pretty delighted that the conditions seem to have abated. And this race due to go off very shortly indeed. That's Joanna Schnaff of Italy, third in the Super G standings on the World Cup. She'll be going with the bib number three. And plenty of fans packed into the finish area. And it's good to see, but plenty of Lindsey Vonn supporters as well. Just quickly, where do you see, a favorite in this race?
Well, I think we cannot discount Lindsey Vonn here. This is a great hill for her. I saw her on inspection. She looked calm, quite relaxed. But looking throughout the results from the World Cup season, there's really been a lot of changes. There's been different people on the podium each and every week. So it is kind of wide open, and it's going to make for a really exciting race here. And Super G, anything can happen. It can be anyone's day.
Six Super G races on the World Cup this year. Six different winners. Who will win the big one? The Olympic game, Super Giant Slalom, is about to get underway. Lindsey Vonn of the United States of America into the start hut. Course set by Meinhard Tatschel of Austria. 43 gates to negotiate in the 2 kilometer run. Well, perhaps just a little early into the start hut. There's about a minute or so until start time. But fantastic to see so many people packed into the finish area to give the racers the welcome they deserve. Austria have dominated this event in previous Olympic Games. They've won 4 of the 8. It was introduced to the Olympic program in 1988 in Calgary. The only other nations to take in gold medal, Italy and the United States of America. Can somebody else break that stranglehold that those three nations have on this event? Lindsey Vonn of the United States of America will get this women's Super G underway at the PyeongChang 2018 Winter Olympic Games, and a first chance for us to have a look at this pattern of gates set by Meinhard Tatschel of Austria.
Here we go, it's a quick drop. What's the Dragon's Claw? Not much of a jump. These are some key turns here. Technical turns back and forth. We want to bring speed across the forest road here.
Vonn, the most decorated female skier on World Cup, 81 World Cup wins, 41 in downhill, 28 in Super G, a total of 135 podiums in 390 starts. A phenomenal ambassador for female alpine ski racing.
looking nice and smooth here as she comes into this section where the women's track goes down. This is the Dragon's Back. Here, there's lots of rolls to manage and deal with. This gate's blind. She's right on line, carrying her speed nicely through this section to the lower part of the course.
This is known as Magic Valley. Vaughn, a bronze medalist in the Super G at the Vancouver Games in 2010, didn't go to Sochi because of knee injury, has fought hard to become an Olympian here in PyeongChang. A little late in the line there, and she is really in trouble. The error coming right at the bottom of the challenge for Lindsay Vaughn. What time can she set? It's 1:21.49. But sadly, I don't think that'll be enough for her. She looks to the heavens because of that mistake, three gates from home. It was so close, but it's not to be, I don't think, for Vaughn.
And she knows that's the last big left-footed turn. She just came in a little too direct. And that's flat, it loses speed coming off the last jump.
Vaughn has to overcome the disappointment to wave to the crowd, but she does that. Huge disappointment for Vaughn. It looked very sharp until that point. And the racers will know now that they have to concentrate right to the very end. Then. Bib number two, Tessa Worley of France, the reigning giant slalom world champion. Will the bottom half of this track suit her style? She's twice a world champion in giant slalom. Sam Maritz in 2017 after Schladming in 13. All of her 11 World Cup wins have come in GS, but her best Super G finish is fourth this season in Lake Louise.
Yeah, she started to do a really good job of blending her giant slalom skills with some speed skills here. So important to be really good on inspection in Super G, knowing where you have to make some more technical turns and where you can find some downhill skills. Oh, really clattering the gate there, and it pops out of the snow.
Well, she's over 7Ks down on the speed gun from Vaughn. We know Vaughn is a speed queen. She loves the speed events. It's just too fast coming into the bottom. Big mistake from Vaughn, three gates from home. Worley through the Dragon's Back into Magic Valley, 1.47 off the pace of Vaughn, and this is where Vaughn got it wrong.
A little bit better around the left-footed corner there. That's the line you want to come in for the approach and the final jump.
1:21.49 for Vaughn, and Worley's not going to beat it. She's outside by a long way. Vaughn clearly very quick on the top. But you feel that mistake will cost her. Worley's not sure where it all went that time. Over 2 seconds off the pace.
Yeah, just losing a bit of speed the whole way down there. You see the mistake on the flats really getting her head on the gate. And we've certainly seen Lindsay Vaughn in the past win races with big mistakes because she can carry a lot of speed through the other sections, but now Lindsay will just have to wait and see for the other racers to come down.
No, it's just with the terrain, like if you come in with speed, then it's hard. If you don't, then it's not hard.
Joanna Schnaff of Italy, bib number three, the top seeds in Super G going on the odd numbers between 1 and 19. Schnaff third in the Super G standings from the World Cup. She registered her first Super G podium this season, a second in Cortina, just before the women came to PyeongChang. Fourth 8 years ago in Vancouver, didn't go to Sochi.
Nice strong turns here. She has absolutely no reason but to be anything but confident coming into this Olympic race.
Well, the Italian team in general, the women's Italian team, just so strong in nearly every single discipline on the World Cup this season. Big jump, landing at 95 kilometers an hour, 58.9 miles per hour if you prefer.
Oh.
You can see she's got a lot of time on Vaughn. And Vaughn didn't make any mistakes up here.
No, she didn't. Schnarf seen skiing very well through the middle section, finding some extra speed.
Just under 55 miles per hour on the speed gun, coming to this key turn. Here it comes now. And she gets her line right. This could be our new best time. 1:21.49, Von's time, and Schnaaf is inside by 0.22 of a second. Von won't be adding to her solitary Olympic gold medal in Super-G. It's Joanna Schnaaf of Italy who stands in gold medal position right now.
Yeah, great run for her. Clean from top to bottom. This hill doesn't have any really steep dropping technical sections, and so really important to be precise from start to finish.
All smiles for Italy and Joanna Schnaaf.
No, it's just with the terrain. Like, if you come in with speed, then it's hard. If you don't, then it's not hard. God damn it.
Number four, Nadia Fanchini of Italy. Her third Winter Olympic Games, 10th in 2014. Of her 13 World Cup podiums, four have come in Super-G, including one win, but that nearly 10 years ago in Lake Louise.
And she's coming off a pretty big injury from last season, really damaging her upper arm. And has had some good form. Whoa, really flies off the forest road, but manages to snap off a really clean turn.
Well, she's quicker than her compatriot, Joanna Schnaaf, who leads the way by 4 kilometers on the gun, but does the clock like it? Well, she's clawed 0.03 of a second back. Fanchini very much in touch as she comes into the part of the course, the Dragon's Back.
No, I think there could definitely be some speed found down here. All of these little spots. She's got the best speed on the exit of the Dragon's Back as she makes her way down.
55 miles per hour. And the next time spit, well, she might be quick, but she's low there, for example. And just those extra few centimeters that you have to ski equates to tenths or hundredths of a second on the clock. So Fanchini over the final jump, 1:21.27 is Schnaaf's time, and she is outside by 0.61. She goes third. So Von could have been very quick without that huge mistake three gates from home.
Have a look here as she comes across the forest road. Gets kicked quite high in the air.
Swiss flags fly. Not for Corinne Suter, they'll fly for her in a minute. But they fly for bib number five right now. Lara Gooch of Switzerland, 12 World Cup Super-G wins. She stands on top of the World Cup Super-G standings. She won the final Super-G before coming to PyeongChang. That was in Cortina, and that was a long-awaited win after injury at the World Championships in St. Moritz in 2017.
Well, a quick little check there with the skis. Snow on the track. Being quite aggressive. You don't really want to push the skis sideways like that. Keep the skis arcing nice and clean and smooth around the turns.
0.02 off the pace at the first time stick. She's 3K short on the speed gun, but that's nicely done over the Zhongbong drop. Now, has she found any time in that middle section? The answer is, well, yes, 0.01 of a second. So she halves the deficit. Very much in touch. Here is Lara Gooch. Down Dragon's Back and in now to Magic Valley.
Still really important to keep the shoulders low down here. Find your tuck wherever you can. These turns don't swing back and forth too much, but they come at you quick.
Well, she's lost an awful lot of time, 0.37 of a second. Lara Goot trying to gets an Olympic gold medal, and she's right in the back seat and has to check through the blue gate. 1:21.27, she's inside though. She's inside, even with the big mistake. Lara Gooch sets a new best time. She's delighted but frustrated all at the same time. Delighted to be in gold, but she's thinking that could have been quicker.
Yeah, let's see. This is higher up, but down on the bottom, you know, she had a few little mistakes, but she was keeping it a bit loose. And sometimes that's the key to finding some speed in the Super G event. Here's the bottom jump. All sorts. Really out of position. Sneaks around the second to last gate.
Swiss coach is delighted, but will it stand the test of time? Bib number six, Corinne Suter of Switzerland, her best result this year on the World Cup in Super G, of ninth in St. Moritz. She's got four other World Cup top tens in Super G. The other one came, another one came this season when she was 10th in Lake Louise. So she started the season strongly, did Suter. But probably prefers the downhill where she has a best finish of four.
Yeah, right out of the start here, down the first pitch, making some nice clean turns. Pops over the forest road. This is the approach to the Zhongbong drop. Now the course starts to flatten out here a little bit, holds her tuck nicely.
But she's nearly half a second off the pace. Just that little bit of air as she drops low in the line. Coming into Dragon's back is going to cost her more time, you feel.
Yeah, just seems to be getting thrown out of position on the exit of the turn. Has to, this is a little bit of time off the ski. A little bit of time lost each and every turn.
Just a tenth of a second lost. The idea is to try and do as much of the turn above the gate as you can so you can carry speed out of the turn. And Schnarr over the Ararang jump, like her compatriot Gute, a little bit in the back seat, but lands it, and she's outside by a second and a hundredth.
Trying to keep it together off the jump higher on the track, swings the arms. Great images here as the ladies race down the track.
That's our leader, Lara Gute of Switzerland. Bib number seven, Tina Weirather of Liechtenstein, looking to add to the family collection of Olympic medals. Her mother won silver medal in this discipline in Lake Placid in 1980, but her mother also won double Olympic gold in slalom and giant slalom in Lake Placid in 1980. Her father is a world champion in downhill. Can Tina Weirather find an Olympic medal?
Well, she's looking confident coming right out of the start gate, really clean around the Paradise turn.
Six of her eight World Cup wins have come in this discipline. That was really neat off the Zhongbong drop. She is the defending Crystal Globe Super G champion. The Crystal Globe is the prize given to the best athlete in each category over the World Cup season. And that's the first mistake from Weirather coming into the Dragon's back.
This gets a little bit twisted and low in the line. She can find some more speed down here. Has to keep these shoulders down, keep working the ski above the gate so she can carry her speed on the exit of the turn.
And she does still have the green light by 5/100ths of a second. Needs to get this turn right, this combination, this left, this right. Is that too wide? Was that a meter too far on that right-footed turn? 121.23, no! Oh, by 1/100ths of a second. The smallest amount of time that we measure in ski racing. Heartbreak for Gute. And she now thinks back to the jump where she was in the back seat, but Weirather has the same feeling that her mother must have felt in 1980 in Lake Placid.
Well, that was a great performance. And again, stay keeping it tight and clean over the last jump. Possibly gave her that extra 1/100ths of a second over Lara Gute.
We wondered if that right-footed turn coming into the jump was a meter too far. Well, she probably had another half a centimeter she could have skied. Jasmine Fleury of Switzerland, the next to go. Her maiden World Cup win came in St. Moritz this season in Super G. She was fifth in the test event here last season.
Nice and clean on the opening turns. Smoothly across the forest road. Now needs to carry her speed across these couple of gates to take it right up and over the Zhongbong drop.
Mike Varreiter very tidy over the Zhongbong drop. Has she made up this 1/100th of a second at the next time split? Well, no, she has not at all. She's lost a huge amount of time.
Well, any little subtle hesitation on a Super G course, the time can go quickly. And here, shoulders just up a little bit, getting pushed around the line.
It opens up as she tries to stand strong on that right ski. Bounced onto that left ski turn, a little low in the line, very late in the line. And 121.22 is not going to be better. She's outside by over 2 seconds. Disappointment for Fleury. Goes into seventh position. That's a good recovery off the Ararang jump. Tina Virat will be looking up the hill. Bib number 9 is the Super G World Champion, Nicole Schmidhofer of Austria. 4 World Cup podiums to her name in her career, 3 of them in Super G, 2 have come this season, 3rd in Lake Louise and Cortina. She's been very relaxed in the build-up to this race. She's been out doing cultural visits. She's gone on record as saying, you know, I don't want to be in the athlete's visit, going to bed training, it'll get the nerves up. So she's gone out, she's taken in some culture. Can she relate that to race day and speed?
Well, there on the Paradise turn, just pushed a little bit wide, but the turn's looking nice and loose and relaxed. That's how you're gonna be able to carry your speed through the turns.
But she's lost a huge amount of time between intermediate 1 and 2, and that's something we've seen in all the speed races that we've witnessed in the first week here, that section on this Super G course is intermediate 1 and 2, but later on it'll be between 3 and 4 on the downhill, is a key section.
Yeah, it really is. Some key technical turns there and over some of the jumps, and really important to get it right, to carry your speed from one section to the next.
Well, she's found some time in Dragon's Back and Magic Valley, but Schmidhofer has surely left herself too much to do. It would be some sort of comeback if she overcame a second, but 121.22 is the time she's aiming for. And she isn't, she's over a second off the pace. It's to be no gold double for Nicole Schmidhofer.
Now she will be a little bit disappointed with that. She knows that she can be right in there amongst the fastest.
Shrug of the shoulders, she'll be back. 4 years old. Tiffany Gauthier of France is bib number 10. 24 years of age, made her World Cup debut 2 years ago. 2 fourth place finishes in Super G and downhill in Bad Kleinkirchheim. Set the bar for her and almost probably secured her spot in this French Olympic team.
Ooh. Yeah, absolutely. Oh, getting a little bit out of position here on these opening gates. Quickly into a tuck. To carry your speed across.
Whoa.
Goes off out of the exit of the forest road in the back seat, has to recover.
off the Jeongbon drop, 21 meters as we look down from wire cam. 2/100ths off the pace at the first, just surely must be more. Well, it's not as much as you would think, given the error off the roller in the Forest Road. Can she find time and speed through this dragon's back? She looks quick on the speed gun.
Yeah, she's looking nice and confident in the turns here. She enters into Magic Valley, has to keep it together here. Keeps coming at you, finds her tuck. Now strong on the right ski. As it falls away, it gets pushed really wide.
It's very steep, that little traverse. It doesn't look quite so bad on the TV camera, but it really does pull the skier down to the right-hand side. Oh! And she almost goes down. Two gates from home, catches an edge, 1.34. The heart will be racing. Gauthier, though, down in one piece.
Well, Gauthier showing us, really showing us some of the skills and the form that she's found in the World Cup, but just unfortunately a few too many errors in the line has cost her some time. And there, good recovery on the finishing Arang jump. Ooh.
Well, the emotion of seeing the Olympic title taken away from you. So 10 races have been in this ladies' Super G, and these are the provisional standings. Tina Weirather of Liechtenstein leads the way by 1/100th of a second from Lara Goot, who in turn is 0.04ths of a second in front of Joanna Schnarr. That is an incredibly tight podium. And Weirather, whose mother, Annie Wenzel, won 2 gold medals at the Lake Placid Games in 1980. And a silver medal at the Lake Placid Games in the Super G. Well, what a story that would be if she could go some way to emulating her mother. There is the defending champion, Anna Veith. She won the title as Anna Fenniger back in 2014. She's been through the injury wars in the intervening years between Sochi and now. So many intriguing stories possibly could be written, depending on who wins this ladies' Super G gold medal. Sophia Godja, number 13, won the downhill and the Super G at the test event here last year. We could go on and on.
Yes, we could.
Ragnar Mowinckel created history earlier in these games by winning Norway's first female alpine got a medal since 1936. Can she double up? Vicky Rabensberg, Germany's big hope. A giant slalom world champion from 2010. Oh, in fact, she's the Olympic giant slalom champion from 2010, excuse me. Federica Brignoni, number 11 from Italy. 7 World Cup wins in the last 2 and a bit seasons. 4 of them in giant slalom, 2 of them in Super G. And she was part of that first Italian clean sweep at Bad Kleinkirchheim in the downhill. Her mum, Maria Rosicario, raced at the Lake Placid 1980 games and in the 1984 games in Sarajevo.
Brignoni, just a really exciting racer to watch. Has this ability to really keep the skis nice and smooth through the whole turn and the ankles nice and loose. And that's where she finds her speed each and every turn.
So Brignoni has a lot of work to do, even to get on the podium. The podium place is separated by 5/100ths of a second. It really couldn't be much tighter.
Needs to keep it really precise and clean down here on the lower part of the course. She enters the Magic Valley. There's a few turns down here. You've got to get the line right so you can carry your speed.
Well, she's found the speed. Brignoni and Italy now have the green light to their name. Can she negotiate these final couple of gates? Good through the line there. Weirather, our leader. Hart will be in the mouth. A little in the back seat. 1:20, 1:22. She's outside by 0.27 of a second. Weirather knew that was desperately close. Oh, my word. Brignone can't even find a place on the podium.
Well, she kept it exciting. She found some time in the lower part and then lost in the final corners.
But just look there, a thumbs up to her teammate, Joanna Schnarf, who's in bronze medal. Almost her first thought, I haven't got a medal, but my teammate has. Fantastic.
Exactly.
Tells you about the team spirit within the Italian group and probably why they've dominated so much on the World Cup this season in a number of disciplines.
You're absolutely right. They have a ton of fun together. They're great teammates. And you really see it right there, cheering on her teammate.
Bib 12, Lauren Ross of the United States of America. You can bet your bottom dollar she's had a course report from Lindsey Vonn and the rest of the coaches. And it's a good start from Ross. Vonn was quick but had a massive, massive mistake right at the end of the challenge, four gates from home, that cost her a medal. Can her knowledge and feedback give Lauren Ross an opportunity to get on the podium? 2 World Cup podiums to her name, one of them in Super-G back in Soldier in Andorra, but that was March 2013. Now, here's the second time split, 40.83. She's outside by 0.77 of a second.
Can she find something extra down here? A little twisted on the entry and offline into the dragon's back.
We saw Brignone pick up nearly half a second in this section, so it is possible, but Ross is going to have to find that and some. And she finds just a little bit, 1/15 of a second.
Onto the left foot around the magic turn. And now it's just a quick drop into the finish area.
Gets the weight right off the Ararang jump and finishes in 1:22.17. And seventh place for Lauren Ross, 0.95 off the pace. Fantastic reception from the crowd here. And Lauren Ross soaking it all up, and so she should. Tina Varreiter, still our leader. Varreiter watches on, because bib number 13 is Sofia Godja. She won the Super G test event here last season. 5 Super G podiums in her career, 2 of them this season, both of them Val d'Isère in France in December.
Let's see here. Needs to be technically strong on these opening turns. And now as it comes across the forest road, that's a smooth, carry her speed right across this side hill turn.
Oh, that is fantastic from Godja. It looks good, but will the clock say it's good? She's skiing with so much confidence right now because of her results on the World Cup. Has she found time? She has. Finds nearly 3/10 of a second. It was as quick as it looked, and she's tight on that gate as well. The red gate coming into the dragon bag. Oh. And as I say that, she gets bounced out of the course, but manages to control herself somehow. Oh, what a shame for Sofia Godja. But Varreiter's gonna see off another challenger.
That was some recovery, getting kicked and bounced by the train in the dragon back section. Oh, bounced around a little bit on the inside ski.
You would think that that's shaved off too much speed to get the better of 1:21.22, but we'll wait and see. 1:21.22 comes and goes only by 0.43 of a second. Well, Sofia Godja, it's a case of what might have been, but it's the same for a number of athletes that have taken on this challenge.
Well, that's all it takes. Here's the mistake. Unbelievable recovery. Pushes the ski sideways quickly and just makes it around the red gate. Well, and she knows that that's what has lost her the race.
Varreiter's reaction as Godja gets pitched forward. And that is Sofia Godja, who you can hear venting her frustration. I guess it's one of those things, if you lose a medal because of something beyond your control, so be it. But she'll be deeply frustrated. Watch out for her. Come downhill day.
Yes.
Victoria Ravensburg of Germany wears bib number 14. Struggled last year with back injury and a fractured tibia. A new coach this year, Jürgen Klaller, who was with the Austrian team for 20 years. And she has shown some form.
Again, really strong in the giant slalom discipline, but has really found a way to be fast on her downhill and super D skis. And this could be a great track for her.
Off the jump, sorry. Here's the next split, 40.83. She's outside by nearly half a second. That is gettable through Dragon Ridge if she skis it cleanly.
Yeah, we've seen a few errors down here in the lower section where we've seen some racers pull back some time. Big puff of snow there on the exit of the Dragon's Back.
103.95 is the next split time. Ravensburg has found the time and she's tight coming across that traverse. Ravensburg looking to take the lead away from Tina Weirather around the last tricky right-hander. Gets aerial and out of shape. 121.22. She's outside by 4 tenths. Weirather is going through the emotional roller coaster right now. Ravensburg so close. But yet so far, no medal for her because she's not within 0.05 of a second of Tina Weirather, our leader.
And the times are just so stacked up. Did well through the middle section. Dragon's Back in Magic Valley to find some extra time, but loses it on the final two turns before the Arang jump.
Another skier who thinks what might have been.
Hey, nice, it's knapp alles.
Huge disappointment for the German coaches. The defending Olympic Super G champion, Anna Veith, a bib number 15. World Super G champion from 2015. Can she add yet another major championship gold medal to her impressive haul? On the comeback from injury, it hasn't been smooth, it hasn't been easy. But can she deliver here and defend her title?
And building up to these Olympic Games, she has been finding some better form in her skiing. A little bit wide there on the Paradise turn. Good move over the Jongbong drop. And now has to drive down this little pitch as she can, carry her speed out onto the flatter turns.
Needs to be within about half a second here, and she is within half a second. This is possible down through the Dragon's Back, which she enters now. Looks very calm in the upper body. We'll get one more look at where she is on the clock here. 103.95.21,
well,
the right side of the clock for Anna Veith in Austria. Can the defending Olympic champion secure another gold medal? What a story this would be. 121.22, Veith to take it away from Weirather. Yes,
oh,
by a tenth of a second. Anna Veith of Austria goes into gold medal position. Oh, what a ski from the defending Olympic champion.
Absolutely spectacular. Well, and she came in building some form, but really had no expectations because she knew she was not at her peak level. Sometimes that's what you need coming into the race. No expectations, just go out there and play on your skis. And she executed her run perfectly.
Anna Veith of Austria. The defending Super G champion is in gold medal position here in PyeongChang. Michelle Gesin of Switzerland, the next to go. Three World Cup podiums in Super G. She was second in St. Moritz earlier this season. Anna Veith of Austria is our new leader.
Well, the track's still fast. Somebody else could do it. We could still see some quick times here. Michelle Gissin has really found some great form in the speed disciplines on the World Cup Tour.
Lands at 96 kilometers per hour. That's 59 miles per hour. She has a big lead over Anna Veith, 0.4 of a second. Now, given you can pick up half a second through this section of the course, she really could be on with a chance of a medal here. Michelle Gissin, she has the best speed through the gun, but she's a little late in the line.
Can she hang on here? There, picks up her line a bit better, finds her tuck.
103.74, no, the line was too rounded, but 6/100ths of a second, she can get this back. Weiss lead could be short-lived as Michelle Gissin of Switzerland looks to get another Alpine medal for her country. Over the final jump she goes, 121.12, out of shape she is, and she is outside, she's not even on the podium. 0.45 off the pace. Oh, another case of what might have been. She skied the top half to perfection, but couldn't bring that speed into the second half and was just too rounded in the line.
Yeah, great top section of the course here. We see some great angles on her Super G skis. Really nice dynamic skiing, but not quite enough speed on the lower portion of the course.
And a vibe. Unsurprisingly, in tears, given everything she's been through. Ragnhild Mowinckel, number 17 of Norway, 25 years of age. She won her country's first female Alpine Olympic medal since 1936 in the first week of these games. Can she add to that title? She'll be full of confidence. One of the seeded skiers. They go on odd numbers between 1 and 19. Mowinckel, ninth in the World Cup standings. Looks good over the Forest Road roller.
Definitely looks to be carrying some speed as she approaches the Jongbong drop.
Doesn't seem much wrong with this run just yet. But what does the clock say? 41.33. She's inside by 0.19 of a second. Now, Mowinckel, could she negotiate the Dragons back better than Gissin before her? Sorry.
And it's so important not to give any meters away in the line here, to trust your inspection, to know where the rolls drop away, where the hill drops to the right just here. Oh, and she's lost some time.
Well, she's lost 6/10 of a second as Mowinckel, and she needs, if she wants a medal, to be within 0.11 of the time set by Anna Veith. Big jump, 121.12. She's outside by nearly a second. Mowinckel losing it in the bottom half of the track. Norwegian flag flies, but not to be Mowinckel's day. A very, very emotional Anna Veith is desperately close to Olympic gold medal. Tamara Tippler of Austria wears bib number 18. Her first Winter Olympic Games. Three World Cup podiums, all of them in Super G. Her last came in Lenzerheide in March 2016, when she was third. What can Tippler do here? The Austrian team, always so strong in alpine skiing, and on a high again in PyeongChang.
Absolutely. Let's see here. She manages across, bounced around a little bit over the Forest Road. Big flight and pushed really wide. And now these next gates, they flatten off before the Jongbong drop. Here's the jump. So really important to carry your speed across the Forest Road. And see here on the next time split how that mistake has affected her time.
Oh. 88.5 on the speed gun. Opens up as she leaves the Dragon's back into Magic Valley again late in the line. She's really fighting to stay on the hard, compact snow.
Yeah, and in racing a lot, we say just, you know, you need to find the rhythm of the course, and she just seems to be fighting the rhythm that's been set by the pattern of gates. Getting pushed low on the exit of the turns.
Nice over the final jump. Stops the clock at 122.5. 1.38 off the pace. Disappointment for Tamara Tippler. Still at the top of the course. 19 is Cornelia Hütter of Austria. Cornelia Hütter leaves the start hut. 13 World Cup podiums, 5 in Super G, including 1 win in Lenzerheide in March 2016. Her best this season. Super G aiming at Kleinkirchheim, and she was third. Now, what can she do here?
There we go, nice and smooth across the forest road.
Gets pitched forward and gets late in the line.
Well, that's a key section on this track to carry your speed. Turns are pretty flat as you approach the Zhongbong drop, and you see if she's brought some speed down across the lower part here.
Well, considering the error, she's still very much in touch with Anna Veith's time. You just wonder whether or not it might manifest itself further on down the track. But given you can get half a second back, on this section of the course, this is still very much on.
Yeah, she needs to stay loose in the turns here, nice and relaxed to carry her speed through.
But Hütter sees the red light go up to 0.45. Needs to be within 11 hundredths of Veith's time to get onto the podium. And Hütter off the final jump, 121.12, 0.42 off the pace. Doesn't get much of that time back.
Well, and she will know too that mistake has cost her some time.
On the spark, president of the IOC talking with Anna Veith. Just can't imagine how emotional she must be given everything that's happened in the last 4 years.
Absolutely, it really is. It's incredible the performance that she has done on this Super G course.
Bib number 20, Romain Miradoli of France. A best Super G World Cup finish of 5th in La Tuile in February 2016. Her best this season was 11th. This would be some surprise. She could depose Anna Veith from the top step of the podium.
Well, in Supergiant Slalom, it really is about trusting your own inspection, trusting your abilities on the skis, and then just taking those risks, finding the speed where you can on the course, and being smart through the trickier turns. Here comes one of those places. Gets a little bit out of position, but gets quick onto the right ski and around the Paradise turn.
Flies 28 meters. That's about 58 miles per hour. How is she faring on the clock? Well, she has found some time. Now it's all about executing the game plan on the Dragon's back, and she's a little wide coming into the blue gate.
On the lower part of the track here, can she keep the looseness, getting it pushed a little bit low? This is really important to carry your speed through the Magic Valley.
It looked like she was fighting the hill, and the clock says she was, and she gets pushed low here as well. So has to make more of a turn after the gate rather than before the gate and use the pitch of the hill to increase her speed. 121.12. Mira Doli, can she? Well, 1.24, 16. Have the green lights at the midpoint. Couldn't find the rhythm of the more Super G-esque, giant slalom, sorry, bottom part of the track. Lara Goot is emotional, but so is Anna Veith, because barring something exceptional, Anna Veith of Austria has defended her Olympic Super G gold medal. She becomes the first female alpine skier to defend a ladies Super G gold medal. Tina Weirather a tenth off the pace, Lara Goot in third. And what a story we have here, because Anna Veith was on the top of her game when she had a really cruel knee injury, and she has come back. And there were question marks about her form. Had she managed to get to the top step again? She has answered that firmly. Yes, I can. I am a double Olympic champion at Super G.
Well, she certainly has. And coming into this Super G race, we were looking at other names. Some of the other starters that have been stronger in the Super G event over the World Cup this season. And she snuck in there. She didn't have the same kind of expectations, even though we knew she was the Olympic champion from 4 years ago. And she skied the run of her season, absolutely, and should be incredibly proud of how she has come back from her injury.
Has the leopard spots on her helmet. It is a snow tiger that is the mascot of these games, but what a magnificent performance from Anna Veith, and she will be a worthy Olympic champion. Tina Weirather, one of the first to congratulate her. Huge disappointment for Weirather losing that top spot, but it just shows the quality of these athletes that they can congratulate someone who's beaten them. Bib number 21 is Kira Wiedel of Germany, 21 years of age. Best results come in downhill, where she was eighth in Lake Louise this season. This is her first race on the hill. She's had one free ski session on this hill. Just try and explain how difficult this run is for her.
Well, especially in the Super G, you don't get a training run beforehand. As you said, just a free ski run, and it's a different speed when you're free skiing down a hill as opposed to racing around the pattern of gates that's been set. So she really needs to use her time on inspection well to execute here on a race run.
Maybe one to keep an eye on in the future. She was third at the Junior World Championships in order in downhill in March 2017. And this will be about gaining experience. Anything more than that, it's going to be a huge bonus for the German team and Kira Wiedel.
Well, not losing much time there. You see it a bit twisted, goes down on her side.
And disappointment for Wiedel. It was going fairly nicely for her. She was quick on the gun as well.
And it can just be the subtlest of mistakes there, missing the timing as she dropped over the terrain coming into the dragon's back.
Lisa Hernblad, number 25. Valerie Grenier of Canada, who is 23. Bib 22, Jennifer Pillot of France, her first Winter Olympic Games. Never better than 13th in a World Cup Super G. She has won on the Europa Cup and fist level races, but this is a different ball game altogether.
That it is. She's been racing on the World Cup tour for a few seasons now. can bring her confidence from the circuit there here at this Olympic stage. Nice and tight in the opening turns. Well, flies quite a bit over the out of the forest road. Has to push the skis a little bit sideways on the exit of the paradise turn.
Flies 31 meters for Jong Bon drop. Now 41.33 is Veith's time at this second split. And Pio is not too far away at 0.48. And another one that just doesn't read that roller, the red roller coming into Dragon's back and gets low in the line. And it will cost her time as she makes her way down through Magic Valley.
Let's see, can she keep dynamic here and hold her tuck position, keep the shoulders low to carry her speed?
Sets up now for the Ararang jump and the final shus. 121.12 comes and goes, and it's 122.38, 17th place for Pio of France. Valerie Grenier of Canada, 22nd here last year at the test event. Came 15th, there was a super combined in Lenzerheide just before they came here, where the speed part of it was a super G before the slalom. She was 15th there. So Grenier, if she can tap into that sort of run, will be in a good place.
Absolutely. Great technical skier, building her experience on the speed tracks in the Super G and downhill. Let's see, over the Jeongbon drop. Got a really nice overhead view here. Has to come out of her tuck a little bit to get the turn finished. Well, and she's quick through the next split time.
Well, 41.33. Grenier then messes up the entrance into the Dragon's back.
Well, there you see one little mistake. The work needs to be done before you go over that breakover. So you land online and can be quick to the new turn.
Let's see how much time that has cost Grenier. And the answer is, well, it is 3/4 of a second. It's not nearly, it is 0.75 of a second. Oh, and then gets, oh, she's desperately low here. She's gonna be in real trouble. Well, Grenier, 122.77, 1.65 off the pace. Forget about the bottom half. Fantastic top half. She was leading.
Absolutely. She knows that she can do it. She's got some form. And just perhaps making a few errors in two of the key sections in the lower half of the course, and that's cost her that time.
21 years of age. Time, touch wood, is on her side. She will learn from that. A lot of positives to take for that. She'll be really disappointed right now. Candice Crawford of Canada, 23 years of age, fifth at the Junior World Championships in Hafia in 2015. So another one that perhaps this is a learning experience for her. But who knows, she might just let it all flow on race day.
Absolutely. At the Olympic Games, anything can happen. Oh, it bounced around a little bit, but recovers nicely, smooth into the paradise turn.
Four top 30 finishes in World Cup Super G's, a best of 22nd Soldier in Andorra in February 16. So an opportunity here for Crawford to really put down a marker for her in seasons to come. 0.68 off the pace, no disgrace at all at that section of the track.
Comes in nicely to the Dragon's back. Now in the lower part of the course, it's a matter of keeping those shoulders down, trusting your inspection line, letting the skis run. A lot of speed can be found down here. It's a matter of trusting that.
Crawford, One big turn from home. Now sets up for the finishing jump. 121.12, and Crawford goes in to 23rd, 2.57 off the pace.
There's a little mistake higher up on the Forest Road.
Is 21-year-old Lisa Hörnblad of Sweden in her first Olympic Winter Games. She was fourth in downhill at the Junior World Championships in Åre last year, 11th in the Super-G. Her best Super-G performance this season, 22nd in Cortina.
Just such a great course that's here. Oh, getting a bit wide, out of position in the air. The snow really couldn't be better for it for an event like this. Barely a mark on the track.
And half a second off the pace of Veith. If she can get this sorted through Dragon's back, she could be okay, but she was a little offline coming in.
Now into the Magic Valley section. Really some beautiful turns down here. Swings back and forth nicely.
Well, loses almost a second through that section of the track. Hörnblad setting up for the finish now. 121.12 is the time of Anna Veith, our leader, and Hörnblad is 1.67 off the pace, goes into 21st position. Bib number 26 is Ester Ledecká of the Czech Republic, and she's about to write a new page of history at the Winter Olympic Games, because this young lady, 22 years of age, is the world champion in snowboard parallel GS, and she came second in the slalom in 2017. 20 World Cup podiums in snowboarding in 40 World Cup starts. She's won 10 of the last 12 World Cup Parallel GSs she's raced. She came 21st at the Alpine World Championship. She's a phenomenal athlete, and she'll become the first athlete, male or female, to compete in both events at the same Olympic Games.
It's just spectacular, and watch her coming down here. Really nice technical turns, great position on the ski, and she's really, you can tell that she has been working hard to develop her alpine ski or alpine skills.
I like the way she talks to herself down the hill, and she's doing incredibly well.
Wow.
Good recovery from Ledecká. The 22-year-old from the Czech Republic is not here to make up the numbers. Fantastic skiing from Ledecká. Where is she on the clock now? Oh, she's got the green line. This would be a story. And then she gets pushed low in the line. Ledecká, five gates or six gates from home, comes up with a massive mistake. It's been brilliant until then. Ledecká tucks for the line. 121.12. What another recovery from the youngster. Oh, she's taken the gold. She has taken gold. Ledecká from the Czech Republic cannot believe it. She cannot believe it. Nor can we. She is there, the world champion in parallel giant slalom snowboarding, is in gold medal position here. Can you believe it? She had two massive errors, but she's standing on the top step of the podium by 1/100 of a second.
She's absolutely stunned, as we are here. That was unbelievable.
Well, back to the top of the hill, because Alice McKennis of the USA, we're just trying to get our breath back here with the commentary box, because we have witnessed something unbelievable. I'm struggling to put it into words. Alice McKennis now, the United States of America, one cup World Cup podium in her career. It was a downhill win in St. Anton in January 2013. She secured her first top 20 Super G finish this season in Val d'Isère. It's her second Olympic Games after downhill in 2010. Now, can she spring a surprise here? Ester Ledecká, the Czech Republic, from bib number 26, the world champion in parallel giant snowboarding, is leading here. And she could go on and win the giant slalom gold at these Olympic Games later in the competition.
Well, yes, we're just trying to catch our breath here. That was just spectacular. And Alice McKennis really having a good run down here as well. Some good split times above.
Where is she here now? Well, 0.66 off the pace. The fantastic skiing from these higher bib numbers, excuse me. And McKennis is doing herself really proud here. The top American is Vaughn at 121.49. Now McKennis tucks for the line. She's just outside Vaughn's time. She goes 15th, just behind Lauren Ross.
How did that happen?
Wow, Anna Veith, you had to feel for her, but Ledecká, she had two huge mistakes. She was flying to still have the gold medal after those mistakes. It's just quite incredible. Well, when we said we thought we'd be writing Winter Olympic Games history, I don't think any of us expected her to be on the podium.
No, I don't think so. That was spectacular skiing.
Breezy Johnson of the United States, bib number 28. 10th equaled her best downhill result in Cortina. She's been a constant top 20 finisher in the main speed event, but look, needs to take the next step. When it comes to Super G, never better than 16th, which was in Lake Louise in December 2016. But given what we've seen, maybe the track is speeding up.
Well, it's possible. It's a warmer day today. Sun shining on the whole track. And we saw Ledecká pick up some speed in the middle part of the course, even with some mistakes.
Well, Johnson, can she better Ledecká's time? Well, she is very much in touch. It is all happening in the latest start numbers here. Ledecká had a little error there as well, coming into the Dragon's Back. She then had another little error coming out of the Magic Valley towards Magic Tree, just after this time split now. Where is Johnson on the clock? Well, 0.66 off the pace. Breezy Johnson looking to try and be the second best place racer from the USA. 121.11, Johnson all out of shape. Good recovery, stops the clock at 122.14. Slides into 14th position. And there are three Americans, 14th, 15th and 16th. And this lady here is 14th, the second best American. The cameraman wanting some sort of...
Well, Ledecká just made a few errors, but it seemed to fire up. She stayed with it. She kept driving through the turn, looking for speed, and it's 1/100th of a second.
Ronnie Remy of Canada, the next to go, made her World Cup debut this season. Only raced two Super G. Excuse me, on the season. She's had some Super G races on the NORAM circuit, but really her best results come in the tech races.
Yeah, gaining some good experience here. One of the younger athletes on the Canadian team. Building her technical skills and now adding to that with some turns here on the speed discipline, the Super G.
0.15 off the pace at the first split time. Ronnie Remy now finds herself 2.21 off the pace of Ester Ledecká, our leader, the skier from the Czech Republic, who has never had a World Cup podium in alpine skiing. She dominates the parallel snowboard giant slalom scene on the World Cup. And it looks like Ledecká is going to take the Olympic gold medal in the women's Super G. Ronnie Remy still has work to do as she goes over the final roller. 121.11, and she stops the clock at 125.9, 4.79 off the pace. Goes into 28th position. It's probably everybody's reaction up and down the course. Stunned disbelief that Ledecká has somehow managed to get in front of Anna Veith. And I only say that because she was just phenomenal. Marusa Firk, bib number 30, her third Winter Olympic Games, finished 16th in Sochi, three top 10 finishes on the World Cup to a best of 11th in Cortina in January 2014. Can Marusa Firk find a Ledecká-like line?
Well, let's have a look here. Strong in the top turns.
Well, 1/100th off the pace. This is a key moment. She executes it nicely. The next time split is 41.15. Marusa Firk coming to this time split now on this right-footed turn, 0.59 off the pace. We've seen half a second gained on this middle section. Can Firk find the line?
And the important piece down here in the lower part is to keep the lower legs moving as you get a little bit tired in the legs, to stay nice and dynamic through these turns.
This doesn't look like a bad run at all, but what does the clock say? Oh, he's lost a second in that section. Firk lines up for the Ararang jump. A little bit in the back seat. 121.11, the time of Ester Ledecká of the Czech Republic. Firk goes 25th, 2.07 off the pace.
Otherwise, I need like 3 days.
Marusa Firk is down. So these are the standings of the ladies' Super G at the Winter Olympic Games 2018 PyeongChang. And Ester Ledecká of the Czech Republic is the Olympic champion. She has beaten Anna Veith by 1/100th of a second. Tina Vajrajta collects her second Winter Olympic Games medal with a bronze, 1/100th off the pace. A phenomenal race here at the Jeongseon Alpine Centre, because the lady who has dominated parallel giant slalom snowboarding is the Olympic Super Giant Slalom champion. A phenomenal, incredible, outstanding story. Lindsey Vonn giving her post-race interviews. But as an Alpine racer, try and sum up what Ester Ledecká has just achieved.
Well, I mean, it's hard to say, knowing that anything can happen. The track's in perfect condition, and it's just a matter of what's her mind set to in the start gate. And she was so determined. You could see it in her head, in her body language down the course. She was so determined. She knew what her plan was. She wasn't focused on the time and how she was going to finish. And here she is now, some incredible turns, and coming from a snowboard background. She's worked hard on her Alpine skills. And wow, has it ever paid off.
The Czech Republic have never won a gold medal at the Winter Olympic Games. They have one silver in the men's. They have one silver and two bronze in the women's. No mixed and no open medals. But they have just won their first gold. They claim their first Olympic medal when they beat the Russian ice hockey team in Nagano in 1998. That would have been a surprise. But I bet it's not a bigger surprise as this one.
No, I don't think so. This has been quite a race. We certainly have been on the edges of our seats.
I do them a disservice. I apologize to fans of the Czech Republic. They won gold at Vancouver in speed skating. It's their first gold medal of these games. Bib number 31 is Petra Vilova of Slovakia. In her second Winter Olympic Games, she skied the technical events of slalom and GS in Sochi. Ninth at the Winter Youth Olympic Games in Innsbruck. What can Vilova do here?
She really has some strong technical skills. Nice to see her transferring those over into the speed disciplines. Ooh, and a bit wide there on the Paradise turn. For the Jongbong drop, a bit out of position. Runs online and now has to carry her speed out here onto the flatter part of the course. Now 1.61 off the pace as she enters into the dragon's back. Try and stay nice and tight on the gate, get the work done before she comes to the gate. And then she can carry the speed coming out of the turn.
.23 off the pace for Vilova as she enters the dragon's back. Big flight for Vilova. 1:21.11 the time and 3.15 off the pace. She slides into the top 30. ...34-year-old Alexandra Coletti of Monaco leaves the start hut for her fourth Olympic Winter Games. Her best Super-G finish was 25th in Vancouver. And a good start. She's down at the second split.
She makes her way through the dragon's back. Sharp on the turns, has to keep the shoulders down. Just a little bit low on the line. This is where you want to keep that line higher up in the turn so you can carry your speed through this bottom section of the course and around the final corner, the left-footed magic tree turn.
She was the first female athlete to represent Monaco at the Olympic Winter Games in Turin in 2006. First female athlete to appear at multiple Winter Olympic Games is Coletti. 1:24.01, 2.9 off the pace. 29th position for Coletti. Danielle of Poland in her second Winter Olympic Games, 23 years of age. Her sister Agnieszka raced in Vancouver. So family has now done three Winter Olympic Games back to back. First top 30 at a World Cup event in the Crans-Montana back in 2017. And here, well, 0.6 off the pace and just losing a second in the section coming into the dragon's back. Over the final jump, winds down the windows, heads for the line. 123.21, 2.1. 26th position. Decent ski from Marina Gassianica Danielle. Back to the top of the hill we go. Bib number 34, Barbara Kantorova of Slovakia. Second at Winter Olympic Games. Finished 22nd in Sochi in this discipline. The best result this season came in Lenzerheide in the Alpine combined when she was 28th. 1.88 off the pace.
The dragon's back. Turns really drop away here. Lots of terrain to work with and manage. To do a good job of looking at the course on inspection and transferring that into your skiing on the race run.
Donovan, 2.95 off the pace. She just gets pushed a little low in the traverse. Final jump, 121.1. Gets her weight in the back seat, but lands it okay. 4.19 off the pace, 32nd for Kantorova. Bib number 35, Greta Small from Australia in her second Winter Olympic Games. She was only 18 in Sochi, one of the younger athletes in the Alpine skiing events. Now much more experienced, but she's been through a rough ride in the last 2 years. She's missed two seasons through knee injuries. The first one picked up in Japan, and then the second one picked up in Yongpyeong, where the technical events are being held. So it's been a battle, but she's here, and she's representing Australia.
Let's see how she comes into the dragon's back. Just to keep the technical skiing going while trying to let the skis run. Find some speed down here in the lower part of the course.
2.39 off the pace. Ledecká's time, 121.11. And Greta Small crosses the line, 124.09, 2.98 off the pace, 31st position for Small of Australia.
Good wave to the cameras, the crowd cheering her as she comes into the finish area.
Katarina Polatova of the Czech Republic is out and running. And I wonder what Polatova is thinking right now, having seen her teammate cause, don't think I'd be out of order saying one of the biggest shots in Alpine Olympic history.
No, I don't think so. I would agree with you on the top. The top runners up there in the sitting in the first positions, and Ledecká just surprising everyone with her run.
I could quantify by saying in living memory, it's the biggest shock in living memory in Alpine skiing at the Winter Olympic Games. All over. Oh. Cross the line in a time of 1:24.48, 33rd position, 3.37. Good effort from her. Nope, she's not happy. With a shake of the head.
Yeah, Here we can see higher up. Getting a little bit out of position in the air.
Noel Barahona from Chile. The next to leave at 30, bib number 37. She's 27 years of age. She's Barahona from the capital Santiago in her fourth Winter Olympic Games. Only raced Super G once. That was in Vancouver when she finished 35th. Her father, Juan Pablo, competed at the 1984 Olympic Games in Los Angeles in sailing. Her mother is a former Chilean national champion in windsurfing.
Wow, and she's found her skis and decided to go for the snow. She comes strong on the right ski there. It's a quick little chicane around the blue gate, stands strong on the left ski around the magic tree turn.
Initially, she didn't like skiing. Her stepfather bought a house in the mountain, enrolled her in the ski club, and here you are, competing in the Olympic Games. Great story, Barahona, 36th position.
Hey Chile, how's it going?
Tina Robnik of Slovenia, bib number 38, 26 years of age in her first Winter Olympic Games. More of a technical skier. She's had two top tens in giant slalom this season on the World Cup. What can she do? Super giant slalom.
Well, it's really good to come into the Super G, a speed discipline where you really need some good, strong giant slalom skills to be able to ski technically well. You need to blend that with some the ability to let the skis run. Let them run on the snow and try and find some good high speeds.
Robnik, 2.45 off the pace. Oh, just manages to pull it forward again. Robnik, 124.49, 34th position. Sarah Schlepper of Mexico, bib number 39, appearing in her fifth Winter Olympic Games. Made her debut in Nagano in 1998, where she was 22nd in slalom, didn't finish the GS. It's the first time she's raced a speed discipline at a Winter Olympic Games. And how's she faring at the second speed interval? 2.64. Lives in Vail.
You can see as well here, you know, she's got great technical skills, but just subtle hesitations into the turn and out of the turn, and that's where it's so easy to just lose the speed in the Super G.
Her first four appearances at the Winter Olympic Games were for the United States of America. Her husband is Mexican. Schlepper over the final roller, stops the clock at 1:27.93.
Well, and she's happy with that. A good cheer from the crowd.
Well, I'm glad she enjoyed herself. Yeah. Kim van Ursel of Belgium, 20 years of age, leaves the start hut in her first Winter Olympic Games. Didn't finish the Super G at the Winter Youth Olympics in Lillehammer in 2016. Did didn't race the Super G at the Junior World Championships in Davos in January of 2018, but was 36th at the 2017 edition of the Junior World Championships in Åre, Sweden. And Van Versel.
You can sense the finish getting near. It's the final section coming out of the Magic Valley here.
Check up the right ski before getting hard on the left ski. Lands the jump. Gets the weight forward eventually. 127.6. 38th position for Van Nuysel of Belgium. Sabrina Simada of Kenya leaves the start hub. The 19-year-old, just the second athlete to represent Kenya at the Winter Olympic Games after Philip Boyt, who is now the chef de mission of the Kenyan team, but the first woman from Kenya to represent her country at the Winter Olympic Games. Her nickname's the Snow Leopard, and she used crowdfunding to get here. So a fantastic story for Sabrina Simada. Let's see if she can negotiate this tricky bottom section of this women's Super G course.
Well, and she is doing a good job down here. Look at the hands driving forward, the angles in the lower legs. That's what you want. Get the skis on edge before you come to the gate, so the ski is arcing through the turn.
Lives in house in Enstal in Austria. 23rd at the Winter Youth Olympics in Super G. Nice tuck off the finish. She will finish this race in a time of 1:26.25. 37th position for Sabrina Simada of Kenya. The youngest athlete in this Super G competition, Elvedina Muzaferija of Bosnia-Herzegovina, excuse me. And 7/100ths off the pace of a time split that's just outside the start of the hut. 3.01. off the pace at the second intermediate.
Now she makes her way through down the course in the lower section. Still keep moving, keep dynamic in the turns. Finds her tuck nicely. It's not easy when the legs start to get a little bit tired here on the lower part of the course. Lots of turns being made above, lots of terrain to work with.
25th. In the Winter Youth Olympics in Supergiant Slalom in Lillehammer in 2016. Muzaferija crosses the line. 6.86 off the pace. 127.97. Bib number 43, Anya Monica Chaya of Romania, 22 years of age, her second Winter Olympic Games. She came 30th in the Super G in Sochi. She raced at the World Championships in Vail in 2015. Also skied two editions of the Junior World Championships in 2015 and 2016. So, Chai, coming out of Dragon's Back at 83 kilometers per hour, around 50 miles per hour. Doing a decent job of this Magic Valley section. She's 3.58 off the pace. as she comes to the magic tree turn. Hard on that left ski to bring her around. Onto the right ski to set her up for the final shus. Over the final jump, the Ararang jump, tucks for the line. And she will stop the clock at 125.74, 4.63.
Yeah, and she's happy with that. That is absolutely an incredible accomplishment to be out competing at the Olympic Games down this difficult Super G course and arrive in the finish area.
Number 45 is our last competitor. It's Ola Nish of Ukraine. 22 years of age, bib number 44, Maria Shinova is a non-starter. So the 22-year-old from Liv in her final race of these Winter Olympic Games, her debut at the Winter Olympic Games. Raced at Super G at the Junior World Championships in Sochi in 2016, she was 40th there.
Getting some great cheers from the course workers down the side of the course.
Ola Nish coming out of Magic Valley. 6.73 off the pace, setting up now for Magic Tree Turn. Setting up for the finish over the final roller, the Ararang jump. Sticks the landing, tucks for the line, and will stop the clock at 130.60. She goes into 43rd position. Congratulations to her excellent performance. So the story of this Olympic ladies Super G is one of shock, because Ester Ledecká of the Czech Republic has torn up the form book and has taken the gold medal by 1/100th of a second from the defending Super G champion, Anna Veith. And in third place, it's Tina Weirather of Liechtenstein. The much fancied skiers couldn't connect an entire run. Too many mistakes from a lot of the big names. And Ledecká, yes, she had mistakes, but she had the fastest time, and she is the Super G Olympic champion. As we go down the rest of the finishers, Greta Small from Australia, 31st. Coletti of Monaco rounds off the top 30. Sumada of Kenya finished 38th. One non-starter and one non-finisher in this ladies' Super G competition. So what a story we have here at the Jeongseon Alpine Centre on the Garirang Mountain. Tina Weirather of Liechtenstein, the bronze medalist. And she was beaten by a tenth of a second by Anna Veith at bib number 15. It looked for all the world as if Veith had successfully defended her Olympic Super G title. But it wasn't to be, because at bib number 26, Ester Ledecká of the Czech Republic came down in a time that was 1/100th of a second faster than Weiss. It is some story here, because the lady on your screen is a person who has dominated the parallel giant slalom in snowboarding, but she has translated that success to Olympic gold despite that big mistake coming over the final jump. She just simply couldn't believe it, could she, when she got into the middle, into the finish area?
Well, exactly, and surprised each and every one of us here at the finish area watching a spectacular performance, and with those few little errors, but it seemed to fire her up even more. She kept charging at the course. She knew what she needed to do. And 1/100th of a second. I mean, you can't see that on the course, and you have to feel a little bit for Veith standing there with the lead for a while. But this is ski racing, and it often does. It can happen this way.
So we're now just waiting for the venue ceremony to happen, and we'll be straight back for that when the podium is set up and the athletes are ready. So welcome to the venue ceremony here at the Jeongseon Alpine Centre for the Women's Super G. Leading them out, number 7, Tina Varata from Liechtenstein. Finished in third place. In the middle with bib number 26, Ester Ledecká of the Czech Republic. Has just secured the Czech Republic's first Alpine gold medal. They won bronze with Sarka Sorobska in the slalom in 2010, but now it's the top step of the podium for the Czech Republic, and Anna Veith of Austria is on the left of screen. So Mr. Roman Kompos, the FIS council member, will be doing the honors of presenting the gifts. Tina Varata is on the Olympic podium for the first time in her career. Her mother was a double gold medalist in Lake Placid in 1980. Varata led for some time before being deposed by Veith, but she'll be delighted to win her first Olympic medal. She won silver at the World Championships in Super G in 2017 as well.
Second place, Austria.
Anna Veith of Austria in second place by just 1/100th of a second. It looked for all the world as if she'd successfully defended her Olympic Super G title from 2014. She won silver in the GS at 2014. It's silver again here in PyeongChang, her third Olympic medal.
First place, Czech Republic.
Ester
Ledecká.
Ester Ledecká of the Czech Republic was creating history at these Winter Games by competing in both snowboarding and alpine skiing. She was a favorite for a medal in parallel giant slalom in the snowboarding, but she's taken gold in the women's super G here at PyeongChang 2018. A phenomenal story, the Czech Republic's first alpine gold medal at the Winter Olympics. Just phenomenal scenes in the finish area here. Confirmation then of our top three in the ladies' Super G. No stranger to being in the middle of three athletes in a finish area, but usually when she has a snowboard in her hand. Quite a remarkable story, this. It is a race that will live long in the memory and certainly write a new chapter in Winter Olympic Games history. A sensational setting for a sensational story. Quick last word from you on what we've seen.
Well, it was a race, it's certainly a race to remember. There was some spectacular skiing, some of the top ranked women came out and made some few little mistakes and the door was open a little bit. And wow, what a spectacular performance from Ledecká. Really, truly amazing.
We came here this morning thinking the bigger nations might be standing on the top step of the podium. Not to be. It's the Czech Republic who occupy that spot. One of the most extraordinary stories in Alpine Winter Olympic Games history has just been written here at the Jeongseon Alpine Centre. A gold for the Czech Republic, their first in alpine skiing.
Just a thrilling race, and that's what's so exciting about the Super G event. It's that risk with the balance between risk and being prepared. So exciting.
Ester Ledecká of the Czech Republic has won her country's first alpine gold medal. And she stands on top of the podium and she has beaten some of the established names in women's Super G. A favorite for parallel giant slalom in snowboarding, or she might just do double gold here in PyeongChang.